me today to Wunder's Corner YouTube channel. If you're just joining us today, please subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell to always get notification each time I post a new video. Today we shall be talking about the melancholy. These are the introvert set of people. You know, they are very cool, calm and collected. I told you that phlegmatic set of people are cool, calm and collected. But trust me, melancholic are very cool, calm and collected. Let me say, simply put, they are very reserved. And they are thoughtful. They process their emotion and think inwardly, unlike the choleric and the sanguine, who would express their feeling when you hurt them, when you do something bad to them. They express their feelings, you know. Choleric would not even take any nonsense from you. He or she would tell you, why would you do that? Why would you do this? And give you questions, a thousand of questions for you to answer. But instead of doing that, a melancholic will sit down somewhere and start ruminating over it. Why would she do that to me? Why would she look at me that way? Why would she look at me in that manner? Why would she talk to me in that manner? And they will never call you that you have offended them. Instead of calling you, they would just sit down and start thinking or crying over it. And then, if you have done a lot of good deed to a melancholic, and you do one bad thing to them, they will forget hundreds or thousands of good deeds you've done to them and always remember the bad ones you've done to them. So because they are thinkers, they think analytically. That is why they are very good at creative work. They are highly creative in poetry, at composing. They are good as an artist. They are musically inclined. They are good at creative thinking. They are judgmental because they can think critically. So if you want a good critique for that book that you're writing, just get a melancholic to come and do it for you. They are very perfect. And they are the kind of people that they call delayed gratification. They delay a lot of things to get a perfect result or an excellent result for you at the end of the day. They are very good at doing a job like personal assistant because they are schedule oriented, they are very detailed, they are very organized. So they keep to time, they keep to appointments, they don't delay, and they are very, very organized. All the good strength of four temperaments is embedded in melancholy. So I can say they are the most perfect of all the four temperaments. Okay, now when it comes to work relationship, they are very loyal. They might take time to conclude that they are going to work with you. But once they start working with you, they might not leave you forever. They are contented with the salary. No matter what they are trying to offer them outside, no, they will not go. Because they are contented with their environment. They are always cautious. They don't want to leave because they don't want question. They don't want query. They don't want a lot of things. They are scared of taking risk. I can say that. And when it comes to love-life relationship, they are the set of girls that will tell you, oh, let me go and pray about it. And they will take like 3 months, 5 months to come and tell you, okay, God has given me a go ahead. Okay, now I'm convinced to date you. But once they are in a relationship with you, it is till death do us part. They will never leave you, no matter the side attraction, no matter the side distraction, rather. They will never leave you alone. They are very, very loyal. And they are the kind of guys that are very, very loyal in a relationship. Although they take their time to study who they are asking out, they take their time to know who the lady is, they study you from afar before they ask you out. And once they come to ask you out and you have given them a go ahead in a relationship, you've given them a yes, they can kill you with gifts. They are very, very caring. They are very, very caring. They are very loyal to their relationships, to their babes, to their girls. They are very, very loyal, and they will never look at any other person. They are self-independent. They believe in themselves because they know they take their time to conclude that this is what I want to do. And once they start doing it, they are very self-confident that, oh, this is the right thing I'm doing. And they are very, very critical. They are critical. It might be good, and I mean, it might also be bad, but they are critical. They are so obsessed with you once they are in a relationship with you. They want everybody to know that, oh, I am in love with this person. This is my love life. They come, they are very romantic. They are all over you. They are so possessive. They are so obsessed to you. They are very difficult to please. If you are, you know, they are very organized. If you are living with a melancholy, they are very difficult to please because they are very organized. They put their cream here. They want to meet it there. They don't have problem with you using their cream. But once you use their cream, cover it the way you met it and place it exactly the way you met it, where you took it from. So you don't use a melancholy cream. You don't bring a melancholy cream from here and put it here. You will have problem with them. You have to use their cream and place it where you took it from, exactly the way you met it. If you enter a melancholy kitchen, they have grade of spoon arranged orderly. They have their grade of pot arranged orderly. When you use one, clean it, wipe it, dry it, and return it the way you met it. So you will not have problem with them. If you get to their house, their kitchen, sitting room, bed, everywhere from outside there, the ones you will get to their house, they will tell you, no, you don't put your slippers outside, you bring them in. This is where you put them. You don't wear your slippers on my rug. This is where you actually put them. So they are those set of people. And they are prone to depression because they think they can overthink. They are thinkers. They are prone to depression. They are the set of people when it comes to driving. They have appointment for 8. They are going to leave their house 5 so that they get there before the time. To get familiar with the environment, to get themselves prepared. And they are very organized. They will never late to an event. For shopping, they have to organize themselves also. These are what we are going to buy. So when they get to the mall, they are buying exactly what they plan to buy. They will never buy less and they will never buy more. Unlike the colleague that I told you last week that would plan to buy something, they can buy that exactly what they plan to buy, but they can buy it in excess. They can buy more, but they will never buy less. But the melancholy will never buy more and they will never buy less because they have already planned that this is what I'm planning, I'm spending my money to buy. They are perfectionists, like I said. So their houses, their work and everything is always very organized. They are comfortable with their routine. These people, when they have a particular routine, like, okay, when I wake up this morning, I do my prayers, I go to the gym, I come from gym, I take a shower, I take a cup of coffee, they are comfortable with that routine. They will never change their routine for anything. They are task-oriented than people-oriented because they are thinkers, so they prefer their quiet time. They prefer to spend it on a creative job, thinking, writing, putting some things together, than spending their time with people, gisting, talking, or doing their things that they don't plan for. They are task-oriented, they are work-oriented, they are workaholic, they are not people-oriented. They are good at working as a PA teacher, and they are good parents because they are very calm. They don't get frustrated when they are talking to people. They don't shout at you. Even if you are shouting at them, they just look at you like, oh, this person is running mad. They just look at you. And they now, after you might have scolded, shouted at them or whatever, they can now go to their quiet place and start thinking, why would this person talk to me this way? Am I this bad? Am I a bad person? They will start crying. So they are moody. They can be moody because of this. They are quick to commit to you, especially if you are their employer, if you are their friend, if you are their partner. They are quick to commit to you. Although they may not give you a response, like I said, on time. And once they are committed to you, they will never betray your trust. They will never betray your love. You will gain their trust and their loyalty for life, forever. They will never disappoint you. So if you have melancholy around you who is a thinker, who spends more time drawing, who spends more time on creative work, who spends more time on poetry, you know, there are some children around you who just pick up their biro and pencil and start writing story, even at a tender age. They prefer to be writing stories of what is going on around them in the society or anything than playing with their peers. You know, these are the melancholy type of people that I'm talking about. Some children, you just see them, they put some pieces of paper together and start sketching, start drawing, start cutting dresses, you know, and all these things put together really make sense. If you know this child around you, this is a melancholy child. So do not blame anybody who is like this. What I'm just going to tell a melancholy around me today is that learn to speak out than keeping quiet, because all this, your quietness can have a toll on you. It can have a side effect on you. Learn how to tell your mind to people. Learn how to come out when people do something wrong to you. Learn how to say it instead of burying your own thoughts within yourself and killing yourself. The person who offends you may not know that he or she has stepped on your toe or done something wrong to you. And you, who is getting worried, who is getting frustrated, who is thinking deeply about this, can cause more harm than good to yourself. So learn how to speak out. Learn how to stop procrastinating things, because this is also one of your challenge. You procrastinate a lot, all in the name of trying to get back to someone. In the process of you trying to get back to that person, that suitor that asked you out, you know, he might get another person along the way, or she might get another person along the way. So stop postponing things. Learn to do something fast. Learn to think fast. Learn to act quickly. Do not think too much. Do not think too deeply so that you not get depressed. Take it easy on yourself. Too much of this thinking can cause depression on you and can take a toll on your mental health, which is not good. So take a chill pill on yourself and be calm. Be calming down small, okay? So it is well with us. It is well with you. Know a melancholy around you and share this video for them. Do not hesitate. Do not forget to share my video. Don't forget to like my video. And don't forget, feel free to subscribe and comment in the comment section box below. Till I come your way next week. Bye.